In today's video, we will talk about the methods of oxygen administration. First, we will see what is oxygen inhalation. Oxygen inhalation or the oxygen therapy is the administration of the supplemental oxygen as a medical intervention which can be used in a variety of conditions and for a variety of purposes in both acute and chronic patient care. And the oxygen therapy is used when the patient is having a low blood level of oxygen. The indications for the oxygen therapy or the administration of supplemental oxygen include the cyanosis, which is the bluish discoloration of the mucous membranes and nail beds due to the low levels of oxygen in the blood, anemia, shock and circulatory failure, hemorrhage and air hunger, critically ill patients, asphyxia, and breathlessness. The first method is the nasal cannula method. It is a very simple device in which two cannula are protruding out of the plastic disposable tube, and these are inserted into the nares so that the oxygen is delivered through them. And each cannula is about 1.5 centimeters long. The flow rate in nasal cannula method is usually 4 liters per minute. The next method is the nasal catheter method. In this, a nasal catheter is inserted into the nostril and it reaches up to the uvula. And this is held in place by the adhesive tape. It's worth to mention here that the nasal cannula is placed in only one nostril, and the nostrils are changed every 8 hours in this method. And this doesn't interfere with the patient's freedom of talking, eating, and moving into the bed. And the flow rate in this method is usually 1 to 6 liters per minute. The next method is the simple mask, as you may have seen in the hospitals that many patients are wearing masks to get the extra oxygen. It is used to administer low to moderate concentrations of oxygen, and the body of mask itself gathers the oxygen between the breaths, and the oxygen comes from the source through the pipe that connects to the body of the mask. When the patient inhales, the air comes from the oxygen source through the pipe and also from the room air through the exhalation ports. The patient exhales directly through the ports in the body of the mask, and the flow rate in this method is 5 to 8 liters per minute. The next method is the partial rebreather mask. It has a reservoir bag that is attached to the body of the mask, and the reservoir bag must remain inflated during both inhalation as well as exhalation. The oxygen enters the mask through the small bore tubing that connects at the junction of the mask and the tube. And during inhalation, the air is drawn from the mask, the reservoir bag, and from the room air through the exhalation ports. And on exhalation, 1/3 of the exhaled air passes into the bag and fills it, because this is mostly the unused air, which is called the dead space air, and it contains a high concentration of oxygen, so it fills the bag. And the rest 2/3 of the exhaled air passes through the exhalation ports and is escaped through them. The flow rate in this method is usually 8 to 11 liters per minute. The next method is the non-rebreather mask. It is similar in design as that of a partial rebreather mask, except it has a one-way valve between the reservoir bag and the body of mask. The function of this one-way valve is to allow the passage of air from the bag into the mask and block the passage of air from the mask into the bag. Also, the one-way valves are placed at the exhalation ports. These allow the exhaled air to pass into the environment. And during inhalation, these prevent the entry of room air into the mask. The flow rate in this method is 10 to 15 liters per minute. The next method is the Venturi mask, and it is the most reliable and accurate method of delivering oxygen through the non-invasive means. And it allows a constant flow of room air blended with the fixed flow of oxygen. And it uses the Bernoulli principle of air entrainment. For each liter of oxygen that passes through the jet orifice, a fixed amount of room is entrained, because the jet orifice has holes in it through which the room air enters. And the excess gas along with the exhaled carbon dioxide leaves through the exhalation ports. The flow rate is 4 to 8 liters per minute. The next method is the oxygen tent. In this, a canopy is placed over the patient's head and shoulders or over the entire body of the patient or sometimes over the face only to provide oxygen at higher levels than the normal. The oxygen tent connects to the source through a pipe which delivers oxygen at higher concentrations. The flow rate is 8 to 10 liters per minute. The next method is a transtracheal oxygen catheter. And this requires minor surgery to make a small incision through which the catheter can be directly inserted into the trachea. And this prevents the loss of oxygen into the environment because the catheter is directly placed into the trachea and all of the oxygen that comes from the pipe or the catheter is delivered into the trachea. Thank you. That was all about today's topic.